Whatsup, Sneaky Nation? Sneaky P here, back with week 15 of our Columbus Aviators franchise as the Aviators are getting ready to take on their division rival, the Indianapolis Colts. The Colts have struggled throughout this series, often really not living up to expectations at all, but they do still have one of the best quarterbacks in the NFL in Andrew Luck. They also have some wide receivers for him to work with. They're younger guys, and Parker Hester is no longer with this team. One of the guys they drafted didn't really live up to expectations much like this team, but Andrew Luck does still have some young wide receivers to work with that he is looking forward to getting involved here today. He will be going up against a shutdown corner in Tyrone Stevens, who did an outstanding job last week on AJ Green, but it's a different animal today going against this Colts team on the road, no less. Patterson is back to receive. Mason Johnson is set to kick us off, and week 15 is underway. Here we go. This is going to be fielded in the end zone by Patterson, and he is going to take a knee, which means Andrew Luck and the Colts offense will get things going from the 20-yard line again. A lot of weapons for Andrew Luck to work with here. Kind of a hit-and-miss season for him. They're not really where they'd like to be, but he is doing pretty solid with 25 touchdowns to only 11 interceptions. If this team can rally behind him, they are a team to look out for. And Macklin with the catch right off the bat, a gain of 16 yards, handoff to Mason here, who fumbles the ball and Luck recovers. I think he was down. They do overturn the call, so it's only a short loss there. Mason again on the carry here, nowhere to go. Going to be third down and 8 for the Colts. Andrew Luck scanning the field and will connect with Dwayne Allen across midfield down to the 46-yard line of Aviator territory. Nowhere for Trey Mason to go. A 4-yard loss, though. Mason up the middle this time, gaining those yards back with a 7-yard carry. Third and 7. They are going for a screenplay to Mason on the outside, and this is coming back with a holding call. Third and 10 play action. Andrew Luck, and he is going to throw this one out of bounds here, and Stevens was there on the coverage anyway. That will bring out Matt Scott in this Aviators offense. 15 touchdowns to 7 interceptions on the season for Scott. Again, been filling in for the injuries to Tyson Russell and Brady Rogers, and he is going to throw this one out of bounds, looking for Curtis Harden to start things off. Rodman Scott up the middle, a 4-yard gain. Third and 6 on the left side. Sean Sutton unable to come down with it. And that is a quick 3-and-out, setting up the Colts with great field position here. A 7-yard reception. Second and 3 on the right side, swatted away by Denard Jackson. Third and 3 for the Colts. Andrew Luck going down the right side, and Remorius Culver is there to swat the ball away. First and 10 for the Aviators, and Curtis Harden with a catch over the middle to the 45-yard line, a 23-yard play. Rodman Scott on the left side gaining 3 more. Second and 7, Sean Sutton with the first down catch across midfield down to the 40-yard line of Colt territory. Scott again going down on the play, a 4-yard gain. Second and 4, Scott down to the 32. Third and 2, Scott delivering the first down for the Aviators. A 5-yard pickup to the 27 play action. Matt Scott rolling out, finding Wayne Chapman on the grab for a 5-yard gain. Second down and 5. Sean Sutton wide open. Has a first and more down to the 7-yard line. First and goal. Scott down to the 4-yard line. Second and goal. Rodman Scott nowhere to go. He has been struggling in these goal line situations lately. Third and goal. Matt Scott rolling out, and he is forced to throw the ball away. Nobody was open, and the Aviators have to settle for a field goal. They will take a 3-0 lead, but leaving some points on the board there again. In recent weeks, Rodman Scott struggling in the red zone, something that needs to change before the playoffs as the Colts take over first and 10. And Luck soars this one out of bounds. Second down and 10. Trey Mason gets tripped up there. It'll be third and 10 for the Colts. Andrew Luck scanning the field over the middle, and this is swatted away by Ryan Shazier. First and 10 for the Aviators as they take over. Scott up the middle. 3-yard gain. Second down and 7. Matt Scott this time rolling out. Pressure coming, and he is going down. Bailey getting the sack for the Colts defense. That'll make it third and 13. Matt Scott in a wild throw. Easily swatted down there. An offensive holding. Won't matter. The Colts will take over, and Allen is taken to the ground by Culver after a 6-yard gain. Second down and 4 as we enter the second quarter. This might be long. No, Hardy comes down with it at the 32-yard line. Sean Hardy, one of the good young wide receivers for the Colts, and now Trey Mason has the first down to the 20-yard line. First and 10. Dwayne Allen wide open on the right side down to the 9-yard line. First and goal. Andrew Luck looking for the end zone. Pressure coming. He avoids one sack. Will not avoid the 2nd, Rafael Reyes there on the stop at a 3-yard loss there. 2nd down and goal, 4-yard loss. Trey Mason, a little spin move. He's going to get it down to the 7-yard line. 3rd and goal, Andrew Luck needs a touchdown here. Pressure coming again on the left side. He will connect with Taylor Reed. Touchdown for the Indianapolis Colts, and they will take the lead. Taylor Reed, his 10th touchdown on the season. A very young wide receiver here, really stepping up big time again. They needed more from him this year after losing out on one of their top wide receivers from previous seasons. And Reed is living up to those expectations, putting his team on top 7-3 here. Over the middle, Perryman trying to get away with the spin move. He will gain 6 on the play. Rodman Scott, though, nowhere to go. 3rd and 4 on the left side. Sean Sutton has a catch, but in breaking the tackle, he lost the first down. And the Aviators will punt the ball away. 2-yard carry there. Swatted down by Justin Brown. It'll be 3rd and 8. Luck looking to throw. Pressure coming. He breaks 1 sack. Throws it down the field. A dangerous throw. And Macklin almost comes down with it. He will not do so. And the Aviators will take over as Rodman Scott runs it up the middle this time to the 43-yard line for a gain of 6. Rodman Scott again on the right side, just shy of the first down, going for it one more time, and he will get the first on the play to the 47-yard line. 1st and 10, Sean Sutton unable to make the grab. 2nd down and 10 now. Sutton will catch this on a pass intended for Harden, but good enough to get a first down as Rodman Scott up the middle, a gain of 3. 2nd down and 7, a screen play here. Scott on the outside, almost a block in the back by Curtis Harden there. That'll bring up 3rd and 4. Curtis Harden will make the first down reception down to the 24-yard line. A 12-yard gain. Now Tavon Austin down to the 21. 2nd down and 6. Scott up the middle. It'll be 3rd and short here, and Austin will deliver a first down to the 5-yard line. 1st and goal. Pitch to Tavon Austin on the outside, and his speed will do him some favors into the end zone. Touchdown for the Aviators as he does the Conan, and the Aviators take a 10-7 lead under 2 minutes to go. Andrew Luck has plenty of time to work with, and he will find his favorite receiver, Sean Hardy, there up to the 43-yard line. Luck up the middle, scrambling for it. He fumbles the ball, and McKnight recovers for the Aviators, taking over with good field position here. And Andrew Luck had a great run going there, just didn't slide down soon enough. And that is going to be a mistake for the veteran quarterback. Not happy with this performance there as Rodman Scott on the left side, gaining 4 on the play. 2nd down and 6. Matt Scott trying to figure out where to go, and Chapman gets out of bounds. It will be 3rd down and 3, though, over the middle. Wayne Chapman has the first down, and the Aviators using a hurry-up offense, but Perryman drops the catch there. 2nd down and 10. Rolling out, Matt Scott, another overthrow. It's going to be 3rd and 10 for the Aviators, and Scott with the catch. Not enough for a first down. They will go for it on 4th down, trying for the end zone, and this will soar out of bounds. 10-7 is going to be the score going into halftime. Once again, another defensive battle, something the Aviators have not been involved on much since Devrin Golden took over as the owner here, but it's what we're dealing with, you know. Playoffs are coming. The Colts are fighting for a playoff spot. The Aviators are fighting for playoff positioning. Everybody here has something on the line, and it's really going to come down to who can bring it in the second half. We are back in the second half. The Aviators starting off with the ball, and another long throw there by Matt Scott. 2nd down and 10 on the right side. This one's going to be a bit long too. 3rd and 10 for the Aviators, and a quick 3-and-out after 3 straight long passes there. As this one is punted away by Marquette King, fielded by Patterson, who's going to break a tackle, get on the outside a little bit, across midfield, the 40, 35, taking it all the way down to the 29-yard line, and setting the Colts up with great field position with the chance to take the lead here. Andrew Luck happy for his special teams there, looking down the field, maybe even trying to go to the end zone. No, he settles for a pass to Reed. This is caught out of bounds, though. 2nd and 10, Mason with the catch this time, trying to get away from McKnight. It won't happen. 3rd and 8, Andrew Luck, pressure on the way, and he is going down. Deion Knight getting the sack for the Aviators there, and the field goal will go through the uprights. 10-10 is going to be the score. 13 minutes to go, or actually just, we'll just say 2 minutes into the second half. here. And a great start for the Colts as they hand it off to Rodman Scott on the right side of the field up to the 40-yard line. Second down and six. Scott dragged down for a two-yard loss. Third and eight. Matt Scott over the middle and will find Wayne Chapman, not overthrowing this one. And that is good for the first Aviator first down of the second half. Second down and nine. Rodman Scott on the left side. It'll be third and six after the three-yard run. Going for the end zone, Curtis Harden has it slapped out of his hands on the three-yard line. Excellent coverage there by the Colts. First and 10, Andrew Luck going to try to run here. Not going to happen. That's a one-yard loss. Second down and 11, Trey Mason dragged down by Tyrone Stevens. Third and eight now, Andrew Luck on the right side will find Taylor Reed, who beats Stevens on the coverage there. First and 10, Dexter McCluster, the former Aviator, loses three. Second down and 13. Andrew Luck on the outside slides down at the 36-yard line. That'll bring up third and 11. Andrew Luck on the right side will find McCluster, who is taken down by Jackson on the play as the Aviators take back over. Nowhere for Scott to go. Second and 11. Matt Scott finds Sean Sutton, the 50, 45, 30, 35, 30, the 20, 15, 10, 5 touchdown for the Columbus Aviators. Sean Sutton using his speed to make the play there, and that is exactly what the Aviators needed to happen. Somebody to breathe some life into this offense, and Sean Sutton is there to deliver. 17-10 is the score. Nowhere for McCluster to go. Two runs in a row, dragged down immediately. It'll be third down and 12, challenging the defense, and Remorious Culliver is there for the interception. A picture perfect few plays here for the Aviators, and they have the ball back with a chance to extend the lead. Remorious Culliver making the play there as Rodman Scott up the middle, a 5-yard gain. Second down and 5. Curtis Harden unable to hold on to the ball there. Not used to seeing him drop the ball so frequently as he has these last 2 weeks, but Sean Sutton has a first down there. Now on the right side, Rodman Scott, a 4-yard run. Here is Scott again, and he has a first down, pushed out of bounds at the 28-yard line. First and 10 for the Aviators. Doriel Green Beckham unable to make the grab, almost intercepted there. Over the middle, Green Beckham has it this time, down to the 6-yard line. First and goal. Tavon Austin uses his speed to run backwards a few yards to avoid the tackle, gain some separation into the end zone. He goes for the second time today, touchdown for the Aviators, and they have taken a 14-point lead, really getting their act together a bit more in the second half. That was more of a successful drive. It was still a short field to work with, but the Aviators have all of the momentum right now, and Andrew Luck is going to have to find a way to turn this around as you see Tyler McElroy there, the former Aviator, watching on as his former teammate runs into the end zone. Sean Hardy with the catch, a 19-yard gain to the 38-yard line. McCluster dragged down, second down and 11. McCluster again. Trey Mason went down earlier, and 5 rushes for negative 6 yards for McCluster, and a wild throw by Andrew Luck. They will punt the ball away as Rodman Scott cuts back inside. Side, no gain on the play. Second down and 10. Matt Scott looking to throw, rolls outside the pocket a little bit, and he is off for the run. Slides down at the 31-yard line. A 14-yard play on the left side will find Doriel Green Beckham this time, who takes it to the 38-yard line for a 7-yard gain. Matt Scott again going to roll out the pocket this bit and find Sean Sutton down the field all the way to the 31-yard line. Sean Sutton having a monster game here as Rodman Scott on the right side, an 8-yard carry. Tavon Austin on the outside this time. He is still on his feet down to the 12-yard line. A 12-yard run is Edward Parker, the rookie, all the way to the 1-yard line. Handoff, Rodman Scott is denied. Second down and goal. Scott will not be denied this time. Into the end zone. Touchdown for the Aviators, and they are running away with this one. Rodman Scott, who has struggled in the red zone in recent weeks, finally gets it in that time right through the goal line. Perfect run. And that's exactly what you want to see if you are the Aviators. We need him to get his legs back under him here before the playoffs. This is swatted away, looking for Mike Wallace on the play. Second down and 10. Andrew Luck trying to run, will not get by Casey there. That is a sack. Third and 13. Andrew Luck scanning the field. Pressure on the way, and he throws this one away. That is a 3 and out, and Luck is down on the play. He will be okay as Rodman Scott runs for a gain of 4. Second down and 6. Scott on the outside this time. carrying some defenders with him. Good for a first down. Here's Edward Parker again, taken down with no gain. Second down and 10. Edward Parker once more on the left side. Down to the 40-yard line. Third and 6 on the right side. Intercepted by Rambo. Not a good throw by Matt Scott there. And that will give the Colts the ball back with great field position at the 44-yard line. They are facing an uphill battle, but they are not out of this game yet. Anything can happen, but Mike Glennon is going to take over here as he finds Taylor Reed at the 38-yard line. Glennon again on the right side, finding Mike Wallace this time. Second down and 6. Glennon looking to throw, pressure coming, and he is going down. Derek Morgan on the sack for the Aviators defense there. Third and 14. Glennon needs a big-time play and soars this one out of bounds. They are going to go for it here. Fourth and 14. Glennon down the right side, and Macklin is unable to hold on to the ball. The Aviators will take over on downs as they hand it off to Edward Parker here on the left side up to the 47-yard line. Second down and 6. Parker again, nowhere to go. Third and 3. They try it one more time. Parker unable to deliver, and the Aviators punt the ball away to Glennon to work with here. Reed on the left side of the field, 11-yard gain. First and 10 as we have gone past the 2-minute warning here. Dwayne Allen up to the 47-yard line. The Colts still not calling timeouts, but they are still making some plays down the field as Taylor Reed down to the 31-yard line. First and 10 on the left side. Almost intercepted by Madricus Taylor there, and he has had a few of those drops this season. Hopefully we can rely on him. And now Manti Te'o's girlfriend with the catch down to the 18-yard line. First and 10 to the end zone. Mike Wallace has it swatted away by Taylor there. Second down and 10. Glennon on the right side this time, and Wallace comes down with a touchdown for the Indianapolis Colts. A very successful drive by Mike Glennon, I would say. Manti Te'o's girlfriend playing a key member in the role that led to that touchdown. 31-17 is going to be the score here, beating Tyrone Stevens, no less. Not often a receiver can say that and get a touchdown from it, but it's going to happen here. I think Tyrone Stevens realizes the Aviators probably have this one as Doyle Green Beckham receives the kick there. It'll be first and 10 from the 43. One first down will get the win for the Aviators as the Colts are calling their timeouts. It's going to be third down and 3. It's all coming to this, and Edward Parker delivers. The Colts can't do anything, and a knee will end the game 31-17 as the Aviators get the victory over their division rival, the Indianapolis Colts. Andrew Luck going down with an injury late in the game. I do believe he will be okay, though. Mike Glennon, though, leading a pretty successful drive there for the Colts. And there you see Luck out onto the field. Everything seems to be okay for him. The Colts not happy with their second half performance here. It was really a close game in the first half, but in the second half, the Aviators blowing this one out of the water. And Matt Scott, man, doing some work again in a late game situation. Had a lot of help from the running game so far today. But look at this. Aviators winning every single category today. And that's exactly what they need to continue to do over these last few weeks. We do get Tyson Russell back very shortly. As you see, Matt Scott, 18-33, one touchdown to go with one interception. Andrew Luck, also one touchdown to one interception. Mike Glennon, one touchdown, no interceptions for him as he ends the day with the best quarterback rating. Rodman Scott, 29 carries, only 88 yards, 3 yards a carry. Really struggling today. He did get a touchdown. We did get 2 touchdowns from Tavon Austin. And look at Dexter McCluster, 5 carries, negative 6 yards against his former team. The guy that replaced him, of course, was Tavon Austin, who had those 2 touchdown runs. Sean Sutton, a monster game from him, 7 catches, 159 yards and a touchdown. Taylor Reed with 5 catches for 75 yards. Sean Sutton, 4 for 73. Curtis Hardin, though, not a good game from him. His worst game of the season. 2 catches, 36 yards. No touchdowns on the day for him. Dexter McCluster did have a catch for 5 yards. Defensively, Duncan with 19 tackles. The young linebacker having a great game. McElroy down there with 10 tackles. He did get 1 tackle for a loss. Deion Knight, 1.5 sacks. Rafael Reyes with 1. Casey with 1. Alan Bailey with 1. Derek Morgan with 1, and then Remorius Culliver with a 0.5 sack. Interceptions, Bakari Rambo with 1, and Remorius Culliver as well. The Aviators pulling through today, really all in the second half. Tyrone Stevens did force a fumble. Trenton McKnight recovered. it was weird the first half, a defensive battle again. But our offense finally started to get it together a little bit, getting a big-time play out of Sean Sutton. We need to see a bit more of that. But that is going to be it for this episode. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time. Later.